Welcome, and thank you for joining the Industry Insider webinar, AI and the Future of the Staffing Industry. I'm Amanda Javro, SVP, Chief Credit Officer at Tricom. As an administrative and financial solutions provider to the staffing and consulting industry, it is our philosophy to be an active member of the staffing industry by staying abreast of the ever-changing marketplace. For that reason, Tricom was pleased to launch the Industry Insider webinar series designed to share our expert knowledge and resources with our fellow staffing industry colleagues. One of our core values is to build relationships and become a leading resource to staffing and consulting firms nationwide. Our presenters today are Brad Smith, Chief Strategy Officer, Haley Marketing, and Jeff Gibson, CEO of Haley Marketing's sister company, Recruiters Websites. Today we are listening in on this conversation as Brad and Jeff explore the impact of AI in the staffing industry and how it can be leveraged as both a threat and an opportunity. They discuss the importance of embracing AI to future-proof jobs and businesses in the industry and provide examples of AI tools that can be used in business development, recruiting, and marketing. The conversation emphasizes the need for recruiters to combine AI automation with human outreach to enhance their effectiveness. Live examples of AI tools are demonstrated to showcase their potential in streamlining processes and improving efficiency. The conversation covers various topics related to candidate marketing, resume tailoring, finding more candidates, and to use the use of Talent Scribe for content creation. This Industry Insider session is broken out into three episodes and explore each of these themes in detail, providing insights and examples on how to leverage AI tools for recruitment and marketing purposes. So let's listen in.
Good afternoon, everyone. Thanks so much for joining this Lunch with Haley. Today, we're going to be talking about AI, artificial intelligence, and how it's impacting the staffing industry. All right. Let's have a little bit of fun. So we've gone through a bunch of theory. We've talked about potentials of what could be used. Now I'm going to hop out of the presentation and we're going to look at some live examples. I've got a few queued up. Jeff has a few queued up. And then we'll get into an awesome tool called Talent Scribe. So I'll go through my two examples. Jeff will pop into his. He'll give you a quick overview of Talent Scribe and how it's revolutionizing content generation for staffing and recruiting companies. And then we'll jump back in, answer any questions, and wrap up here. So I'm going to reshare my screen. And what I'm going to show you is something in ChatGPT. ChatGPT's free version. Wanted to show you the free and the paid side, which Jeff will feature. But what we're looking at here is something that anyone can do for free. And I think a lot of people on this call so far are using it for better job descriptions, better job write-ups. And what I did is I just took an open job rec from Indeed, a general job description, something that you'd get, and typed it into ChatGPT. And my prompt was to act as a high-level recruiter. Whenever I do a prompt in chat, I like to tell it how to act, what role I want it to play. I asked it to rewrite this job description. Okay, so again, quick copy and paste. It rewrote the job description. It was okay. It was better. I wasn't thrilled with it. So then I followed up and said, all right, real simple follow-up prompt, make it more engaging. If I was really doing this, I'd probably jump in and tell it how I wanted it to be more engaging. I want a sizzle statement at the front. I want it to focus on what's in it for the end candidate. I want to focus on these key job attributes that I think are really important. But even just that simple prompt dramatically improved this job description. Okay. From there, I said, all right, please develop a short LinkedIn message that I can send to qualified candidates that will make them interested in learning more about this role. Okay. Here's my email. It's pretty good. Now I want to create a compelling email I can forward to candidates with the role description attached. Here it is. Okay. Then I asked it, all right, create a series of 5 social media posts with hashtags that I can share to promote this position. Here we go. Now I want to create 3 versions of a job posting title I can use when posting on Indeed. Here they are. Now I want it to craft an email that I'm going to use to present to the hiring manager when I'm presenting this candidate. Here it is. Now I've interviewed a whole bunch of candidates that didn't get the position or aren't going to get an interview. I don't want them to tarnish my reputation. So I'm going to follow up with them. Okay. I created an email to send to candidates that applied to this position but didn't get the job offer. Bam, it's done. Now I want to prepare candidates that I'm sending out on assignment. I asked it to create a series of interview questions based on what the chat knows about this company, the client company. And here are the questions. All right, but questions aren't good enough. I want it to come up with answers to those questions so that I can educate and prep the candidate that I'm sending out. Here they are. Okay. All of that was done in a matter of about 5 minutes. Now, is it final? Can I just copy and paste and use this all? Maybe, but it takes some human intervention to tweak, to adjust, to personalize it a little bit, make it much more effective. But holy cow, what a time savings. I wish these tools were available for us 15 years ago. The next thing that I wanted to showcase is how AI can help us with market intelligence. So you have salespeople out there that are focused in a specific industry, okay, focused in a specific sector, are reaching out to specific companies. This is, I think, is a great example. Let's say I was doing healthcare staffing. I have a regional healthcare staffing company, and I want to know what's going on with the big boys out there. So here's my script. Please, or my prompt. Please act as a business consultant providing guidance to a regional healthcare staffing company. What can I learn from the recent earnings call from Ammon Healthcare? I just went and I grabbed the transcript from the earnings call. I want to know the top five or top things that is impacting their business because I know it's probably going to be impacting the clients I'm selling to. All right. Here it is. Here's what I need to look out for. Here's what I need to be planning for as we enter 2024 as a regional healthcare staffing company. Let's think about this from the lead generation standpoint. If I'm going in and I'm targeting a specific company, let's arm our salespeople with the scripts and the tools that they can use to streamline their research so they don't spend a ton of time doing digging. Okay, just two or three very specific ways to use ChatGPT. Even the free version, and you're going to get great results. Jeff, I'm going to turn it over to you. I know you have a few examples, so why don't you jump into it?
Sounds good.
Stop my share and take us away.
Right. Should be able to see my screen.
Yep.
Sorry in advance, I've been hacking up a lung here, so I might go on mute if I get the urge to cough. So I have the paid version of ChatGPT. I'm actually today I'm using 3.5 Turbo. I do have four available. With the recent update, I've been having a little bit of trouble with four, so I'm going to stick with 3.5. It's been slow on four. I think that's something they're working on. So I'm going to have an example for you, and I'm got to go from screen to screen here. This prompt is pretty long, so we're gonna look at leading with a candidate. So I'm going to copy and paste in this prompt. And this prompt just I want the AI to be familiar with searching Google, I'm sorry, LinkedIn through Google, which some refer to as X-ray searching. So I'm going to plug that in. And it's going to basically spit out what it understands about X-ray searching. And like Brad, I am going to tell ChatGPT that I'm an executive recruiter and I'm focusing in the insurance industry and I work a full desk. It's going to spit out what a full desk is. And my next prompt is today I'm doing business development. I have a candidate with 10 years of loss control experience working for an insurance company in Chicago. It's looking to move to Boston. And I'm asking it to create for me a search. Now, I'm looking for, not looking for candidates, I'm looking for potential clients. So I want to find director level and higher loss control managers or leaders that I can lead with this candidate, market with this candidate to those individuals. And it returns back to me this type of string. And some of you are probably familiar with that. This is the type of result that I get from that string. And I can go in and I can market this candidate to those individuals. And you can see I have director, VP, senior manager, senior director, and so on. But what's really, really cool about this is I set the Boston area. So I got Boston, Cambridge, Somerville, all these other areas around Boston. And I didn't have to research that. I didn't have to look that up. It just did it for me. As I go down, so now that I've identified these individuals, I want to send them a message on LinkedIn. So I said, thank you for helping me locate several people to reach out to about this candidate. Can you help me write a compelling email? Of course, I'll have to make sure this makes sense and edit it. And then the next example is I'm going to go to a new chat window for. I want to look at tailoring a resume to a job. So again, I'm going to start with a really long prompt. And I'm asking it to not respond yet, but I will supply you with a resume of a candidate I want to submit to this job. And in this prompt is a job description for a full stack Java developer. And the next prompt is the resume text, which I'm just copying and pasting out of a resume. So it's going to start to write the resume. It gives it to me in this nice little plain text box where I can just copy the whole thing at once. And the resume before that, it just looked terrible. It was just a mess. And then as I go down, I wanted to create an email to the client about the match. So it gives a summary of Matthew's background, and he's a strong fit, and it brings up his skills. Now I want to take that to the next level. I want a table. This is something I used to do as a recruiter, would spend time writing up a summary of a candidate, and then I would create this table with the skills, and then the skills that the candidate had matching up for the job. And now I want to modify the table, and I left this out just so I can show you how we can modify this table in chat with just a simple, can you modify this table with a new column with a years of experience? And so we added the new column, and sometimes it doesn't get it 100% right, as you can see. And you can make some modifications. Sorry, I'm trying to go quickly here. Well, it did it in my other example. Let's move on. And
that's the other challenge with AI, right, Jeff? So sometimes you're going to have to play around. You're not going to get a perfect result, but don't let that discourage you.
Yeah, actually, if I switch down, this is another cool feature of chat. It saves what you do. So in preparation for this call, I can actually go up to this table and see where it filled it out the first time. But I kind of like to do it live so everyone sees it. Now the next one is I want to, I need more candidates. So this is just one candidate. So I'm asking it to help me find more candidates. So again, we have another search string of terms that I can use to find candidates like this. And then finally, now that we've found more candidates, again, we need a message to send the candidates on LinkedIn, which is where I was finding them at. So let's dive right into TalentScribe. I know we're pushing it on time here.
I'm excited about this. This is such a cool tool.
So I said earlier that I like to combine AI with automation. And this is what I'm talking about. Taking what you can do in ChatGPT and scaling it up so it just happens and it just does it. And it makes your life easier. So there's two ways to use TalentScribe. TalentScribe is a WordPress add-on plugin that takes AI and helps you write content. So let's say you're on your blog, you don't know what to write about, hit generate ideas, and the AI is going to return back some ideas. And we'll just grab one here, meeting diverse needs in healthcare, and create our post. And in about a minute or two, we'll have a post that we can look at. But as this is writing, here are the steps. So we start with the idea. We settle on the title. The AI will write the introduction, the body, the conclusion. It will rewrite the entire article so it's cohesive because we're writing them all at separate times. And then it will analyze the article for SEO and fill in the SEO metadata. And then the page will refresh, and then we can select an image. So here it's analyzing SEO.
Jeff, while we're waiting there, a question just came in. Is this tool free? It's not, because there is some cost associated with the API calls and everything, but we'll get into the pricing structure of this a little bit. It is extremely cost effective and can dramatically increase the amount of content that you're able to produce that's customized for your company, for your industry, for your individual recruiters. And the quality is quite good.
It will return back anywhere between 800 to 1500 words in a single post. If you've ever tried to generate anything with like chat, it's really difficult to say, make this post 1500 words. It doesn't really listen to lengths. You have to say, make this long or extra long. You can see here, this is a very long article, 1575 words. This feature is in beta. But a LinkedIn post ready to go for the article. And then we can select an image. So selecting an image is really simple. Just click on the image and go up to the top and hit update or publish. And we'll just save this as a draft. And then that image will be set to the featured image. So this is the manual way. It takes about 2.5 minutes or so in total. But there is another way to use TalentScribe. And that is through what we're calling the auto blog. So these are the set. This is the settings area for TalentScribe. And essentially, we come in here and we set this up. And the customer is able to have an email notification go directly to them, how often they want to create blog content. We generate a list of ideas. So we'll generate 100 ideas. When this list gets low, we'll generate 100 more. And you'll get an email every day, every week, every month, depending on the interval that you set up, about a new article that gets ready to be added to your blog. So there's the option to keep it as a draft or to go ahead and publish it right away. I recommend most people to keep it as a draft, which are the options down here. And then we have the option to set the publisher, the author, and then the types of imagery. So we can go into different types of industries. And if we need something custom, we can put in our own custom search here. And then this just puts it on autopilot. And if you like it, you post it. If you don't, then you modify it or throw it away and wait for the next one or just log in and make one yourself. So that is, in a nutshell, that is TalentScribe.
Jeff, thanks so much for that intro. This is an absolutely amazing tool. So just to reiterate, you've got content ideation. So it's going through and doing the content plan strategy for you based on some inputs up front. So it's coming up with all the topics and what your audience cares about. It's going in and writing the post itself. It's finding an image that ties to that post. It's giving you the LinkedIn content that you can share. And you can set it to completely go on autopilot as well. It's absolutely awesome. I use this for myself. And what I love most about it is that it helps me streamline getting a post out. It's very hard to start from scratch. It's extremely easy to go in and edit, tweak, and adjust for your tone, for your company, to tie in specifics. Way easier to edit a post than to come up with it from scratch. And that's what I love the most. So, Jeff, thank you so much for sharing. Now, there obviously was a question on cost. Let me get to that here. So, have a few different plans. So there's a basic content creator plan, content creator plan times two, and then a fully managed program. And you can learn more about those by scanning this QR code, or reaching out to Jeff or myself or our team, and we'll get you a little bit more information on that. But for those companies that have a WordPress site out there, that have a blog that hasn't been updated since 2022 or earlier, this is the tool that you want. It's really cost effective, and it will help you dramatically scale your content creation, and is not a heavy lift at all. If you have somebody in your organization that's responsible for marketing, and maybe they run a desk, maybe they're in sales, maybe they're an admin person, this is an amazing tool for them to make them way more productive. So definitely reach out and learn more. I know that we answered most questions throughout the presentation. Jeff, there was one that just came in on TalentScribe. Do you need a WordPress site for this to work?
Yeah, so you do need a WordPress site, but what you can do is you can just, we can spin up a WordPress instance just for the blog, and then you can use TalentScribe and keep your same website.
Love that.
Do we own TalentScribe was another question. So TalentScribe, yes, is a tool that actually I developed, and we do own it. How does Google and search engines handle AI writing from an SEO perspective? So it's an interesting question. We've actually had some really good success in getting AI written content to be indexed. We haven't seen any issues yet.
Google has come out and said that there's no negative impact for AI content. Basically, they're looking for the best answer to a searcher's query. And oftentimes the best answer is going to be AI generated. So there's no negative impact. And to Jeff's point, we've created long form articles on a specific topic that have ranked in a day or two. It's been great.
Yeah.
Awesome. Well, that brings us to the end today. So make sure that you sign up for Smart Ideas. We've switched to weekly inspiration. So sign up at haleymarketing.com/smart ideas. Every single week, you'll get a great tip that you can implement and start using in your organization to save time, drive more sales, improve recruiting efforts, improve operational efficiency, and just some really actionable, great takeaways. So I want to thank you all so much. I hope you got one or two great nuggets, great takeaways from today's session. And if you have further questions or want to dig into a topic at a deeper level, reach out to me, reach out to Jeff, reach out to the team at Haley Marketing Group, and we are happy to help. Thank you all so much. I really appreciate your time. And Jeff, thank you. That was awesome.
It's great to be here. Thanks, Brad.
All right. Take care, everyone.
Thanks for listening in to this episode of the Tricom Industry Insider webinar on AI and the future of the staffing industry. We'll see you in our next episode.